Good morning students. So today we are going to start our next topic, and that is from our Moments book, chapter number 6. The name of this chapter is Weathering the Storm in Its Summer. So before starting this chapter, so a brief introduction I'll give about this story. So this story gives an account of the storm that hit the coastal town of Itsama in Odisha state in the year 1999. A young boy named Prashant faced the fury of the storm and reached his village. The details of how he worked hard to help the villagers overcome the devastation caused by the storm inspire us to have courage and a positive approach towards life. So this is the introduction. Okay, now let's start the story. The cyclone that hit Odisha in October 1999 killed thousands of people and devastated hundreds of villages for two dreadful nights. Prashant, a young man, was marooned on the roof of house. On the third day, he decided to go to his village. Now, did he find his family? Let's start the story and we will find it out. On 27th October 1999, 7 years after his mother's death, Prashant had gone to the block headquarters of Itsama, a small town in coastal Orissa, some 18 kilometers from the village, to spend the day with a friend. In the evening, a dark and menacing storm quickly gathered. Winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury that Prashant had never witnessed before. Heavy and incessant rain filled the darkness. Ancient trees were uprooted and crashed to the earth. Screams rent the air as people and houses were swiftly washed away. The angry water swirled into his friend's house neck deep. The building was a brick and mortar and was strong enough to survive the devastation of the wind's velocity of 350 km per hour. But the cold terror of the family grew with the crashing of trees that had got uprooted and fallen on their house sometime in the middle of the night, damaging its roof and walls. So what is given here basically? So first of all, the meaning, menacing means here dangerous and harmful. Fury means extreme strength. Okay, keep on writing. All right. Incessant means unceasing, or we can say continuous. Okay. Ancient, old. Rent means here the meaning is filled. Swirled, move or flowed along with a whirling motion. Mortar, that is the mixture of lime, cement, sand and water used to construct buildings. Okay, so Prashant here was a native of a village in the coastal state of Odisha. On 27th October 1999, he was on a visit to a friend in Itsama, which is a very small town in Odisha and a block headquarter in Jagatpur district. His village was at a distance of 18 kilometers from Itsama. He had lost his mother 7 years ago. So that day, a very strong storm gathered in the evening. Furious wind accompanied by continuous rain lashed the place. Screams could be heard as trees got uprooted and destroyed the houses as they fell on them. The water flowed with gush and swept away houses that came in its way. There was neck-deep water in friend's house. Okay, so there were only water all around just because of the very heavy rain. Alright, as his house was a pakka house, it was able to resist the strong winds which blew at a speed of 350 kilometers per hour. His friend's family was terrorized because in the middle of the night, trees had fallen on the house, damaging the roof and walls of the building. Now, the crazed destruction wrought by the cyclone and the surge of the ocean continued for the next 36 hours. Although wind speeds had reduced somewhat by the next morning, to escape the waters rising in the house, Prashant and his friend's family had taken refuge on the roof. Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse of the devastation wrought by the super cyclone. In the gray light of the early morning, a raging deadly brown sheet of water covered everywhere as far as the eye could see. Only fractured cement houses still stood in a few places. Blotted animals carcasses and human corpses. Animal carcasses means the dead bodies of human, that's animal and human corpses, that's also dead body of humans, floated in every direction. All around, even huge old trees had fallen. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. This was a blessing in disguise, because the tender coconuts from the trees kept the trapped family from starving in the 7 days that followed. So children, here the crazed destruction we can see, right, brought by the cyclone, and the surge of the ocean continued for the next 36 hours. So it was continued till 36 hours, all right. Although wind speed was very much high, somewhat by the next morning it reduced, okay. To escape the water rising in the house, Prashant and his friends' family had taken refuge on the roof. So they were on the roof, they were there because there were all around water, okay, till the roof there was water only. Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse of the devastation wrought by the super cyclone. Okay, here beta, just note down the meaning. S-U-R-G-E, surge means gush, refuge means shelter, okay, R-E-F-U-G-E, refuge, shelter, rot, W-R-O-U-G-H-T, it is produced as a result of something, that is rot, okay, W-R-O-U-G-H-T. So, here what is given, the storm continued for next 1.5 days. Although the wind had slowed down to escape the rising level of the water, Prashant along with his friend and his family took shelter on the roof of the house. As the day dawned, Prashant saw the destruction caused by the super cyclone. A raging deadly brown sheet of water covered everything. Okay, so there were only water all around, all right. So they were watching blotted animal carcasses and human corpses floating everywhere in each direction. So this was actually the condition that he was witnessing there. All right. So note down the meaning. Fractured, F-R-A-C-T-U-R-E-D, that is broken. Blotted means swollen. Okay, S-W-O-L-L-E-N, swollen. Okay. Animal carcasses, I told, dead bodies of animals. Okay. Blessing in disguise, that is an apparent, okay, misfortune that eventually has good result, okay, that's a disguise, blessing in disguise, okay. Tender, that is soft or raw, tender, all right. So as far as Prashant could see, what he can see, only the dead bodies. His and the family member of his friend's life was saved just because of a coconut tree was fallen on the roof and they have eaten the fruit, the raw fruit of that tree. For the next 2 days, Prashant sat huddled with his friend's family in the open on the rooftop. They froze in the cold and incessant rain. The rain water washed away Prashant's tears. The only thought that flashed through his mind was whether his family had survived the fury of the super cyclone. Was he to be bewildered once again? 2 days later, which seemed to Prashant like 2 years, the rain ceased and the rain waters slowly began to recede. Prashant was determined to seek out his family without further delay. But the situation was still dangerous, and his friend's family pleaded with Prashant to stay back a little while longer. But Prashant knew he had to go. So, meaning, first of all, we will see huddled together in a group, that is huddled, H-U-D-D-L-E-D, together in a group, flashed through his mind, came to his mind, okay. Bereaved to have lost a family member or a friend to death, okay. Now next, Here, what is given? They spent the next 2 days on the rooftop. Everyone was so scared that they sat together in a group. It was very cold and the continuous rain washed away Prashant's tear. Now he didn't weep after that. He was worried about his family. The only thought that was coming in his mind was whether the family is safe or not. Maybe he could have lost another family member and would be in grief over the loss of loved ones again. This thought worried Prashant a lot. But still, as the rain stopped after 2 days, it seemed to Prashant that the 2 days time was like it was a very long time for him. Okay, it was just seeming like it was the time of 2 years. This shows that it was very difficult for him to pass the time as the worry about the family's well-being. Okay, the rain had stopped and the water was receding gradually. Although it was dangerous to go out, he did not waste any more time and left to find his family. His friend's family requested Prashant to stay back, but he left because the only thought that was coming in his mind was whether his family is safe or not. Okay. Now he equipped himself with a long sturdy stick and then started on his 18-kilometer expedition back to his village through the swollen flood waters. It was a journey he would never forget. So this is actually a very journey. Expedition here means journey. Okay. So with the help of long stick, Prashant started the 18-kilometer long journey back home. As he passed through the flood water, the journey got inscribed in his mind forever. He had to use the stick to guide himself and find the path where the water was shallower. Okay, shallower. S-H-A-L-L-O-W-E-R. Shallower means where the water will be less. So at several points he lost the road and had to swim. After some distance, he was revealed to find two friends of his uncle who were also returning to their village. They decided to move ahead together. As they waded through the waters, the scenes they witnessed grew more and more macabre. They had to push away many human bodies, men, women, children, and carcasses of dogs, goats, and cattle that the current swept against them as they moved ahead. In every village that they passed, they could barely see a house standing. Prashant now wept out loud and long. He was sure that his family could not have survived this catastrophe. Okay, so this was actually a very, you know, the situation that nobody can even explain in words. The situation was like that. Okay, so here waded means swam. Okay, swim, wait, swim. Okay, macabre, that's horrible. Okay, the situation was very horrible. Catastrophe, disaster. Okay, catastrophe, disaster. Now as the group proceeded, they got to see horrible scenes on the way. They had to push dead bodies of human beings and the animals which were being swept around with the current of the water as they crossed villages. Not even a single house was seen there. As Prashant's fear grew, he wept loudly. He was sure that his family members would not have survived the disaster. Now, eventually, Prashant reached his village, Kalikuda. His heart went cold. Where their home once stood, there were only remnants of its roof. Some of their belongings were caught, mangled, and twisted in the branches of trees just visible above the dark waters. Young Prashant decided to go to the Red Cross shelter to look for his family. So, here a remnant means beta, small remaining quantities. Okay, सिर्फ उसके घर का कुछ पार्ट ही कहीं कहीं नजर आ रहा था, otherwise there was nothing. So when Prashant reached his village, so the name of his village was Kalikuda, he became numb on seeing the remains of his house. Their belongings were scattered in the water and some things hung on the branches of the tree just above the flood water. He decided to look for his family at the shelter. So there was a shelter given to those who have suffered from this disaster, this catastrophe. Okay, so the name of that shelter was Red Cross Society. Among the first people he saw in the crowd was his maternal grandmother. Weak with hunger, she rushed to him, her hands outstretched, her eyes brimming. It was a miracle. They had long given him up for dead. So here, eyes brimming means eyes were full of tears. So at the Red Cross Society, as Prashant reached there, he saw his maternal mother. Okay. She appeared weak but was glad to see that Prashant was actually alive. She rushed towards him, okay, with her arms open and her eyes full of tears. It was actually a miracle for her, as the family had thought that Prashant would not have survived the storm. So the situation was same, okay, both the side. Quickly, word spread and his extended family gathered around him and hugged him tight in relief. Prashant anxiously scanned the motley battered group. His brother and sister, his uncles and aunts, they all seemed to be there. Okay, motley means desperate, okay, varied in appearance of character. Okay, battered means here injured, okay, batterred, injured. Keep on underlining the words in your book, okay. Motley means desperate. Kisi cheez ko dekhkar bahut zyada, that's, you know, we just want this thing anyhow. So it can be varied in appearance or character. So this is here, okay. So as Prashant's extended family came to know that he had come, so everybody gathered around him, hugged him in relief. So Prashant saw that everyone was worried and injured. He met his siblings, uncles and aunts there. Okay, children, so this, I will just stop this video here. This is part 1 and remaining video I'll upload as part 2. Okay, till the time, just read it, go through the chapter, go through the video and just underline all the difficult words and write their meanings. Okay, thank you so much for watching.